Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello, what's up guys? Let me introduce myself. My name is Muhammad Pandu Prayogo. I am from Man 1 Kota Malang, Jawa Timur ya. Or East Java. And today I am at 11th grade in the high school. Yeah. In this video I will explain all of you guys about lucid dream. Ya, di video kali ini aku akan menjelaskan lebih detail mengenai lucid dream bagi kalian yang belum paham ya, bagi orang-orang awam. Nah, tapi ini adalah video untuk mengumpulkan tugas bahasa Inggris yang pastinya dominan menggunakan bahasa Inggris. Oke, let's start it. When we sleep, sometimes we saw the process of dreaming. But dreams can be felt suddenly without we knowing why they appear in the subconscious. And the dreams that we often get are impossible to happen in the real world. However, there are some people have experience of lucid dream when they sleep. The phenomenon of lucid dream is a process where the dreamer or we can see clearly in the dream we can move with our own will. Do you know how can we experience the process of lucid dream? Lucid dreams can occur during the rapid eye movement, or REM, in the sleep phase. In other words, during the sleep phase, we are in REM. Our body remains in a state of rest, but our brain's activities is like someone who is doing other activities. In this phase too, we haven't slept soundly. Or in other words, we are between asleep and awake. This is where the process of lucid dream can occur. There are several ways to do lucid dream when we sleep. For example, we get used to sleeping in the REM phase by improving our sleep qualities in every night. Second, make a diary containing the dreams we experience. And last, applying the mnemonic induction of lucid dream, or MILD, yeah. MILD technique. Besides, there are techniques used for lucid dreaming while we sleep. In the fact, there is a way to wake up or leave this lucid dream phase. First, screaming or talking loudly in our own dreams so that it can tell the brain to wake up. Second, blinking repeatedly can help our minds wake up it. And for the last, sleep soundly in the dream. Many benefits from lucid dream for our healthy and daily life, like prevent from bad dream, reduce of anxiety, improve motoric skills, and also our creativity. But there is negative effect if we often do lucid dreams. For example, reduce mental well-being, sleeping, sleep problems, sleep paralysis, and the worst effect is can trigger depression. So, lucid dream is a phase where we as a dreamer can feel thoughts in the dream when we sleep. This is very important for all of us. We can indirectly release what we want can be felt, but not real. But don't too often do lucid dream, because it can harm our health even more our mental condition. Ya, jadi intinya kalau lucid dream adalah sebuah proses dalam mimpi yang bisa kita jalankan sendiri, jadi kayak dunia lain ya. Positif dari lucid dream ini lebih ke nyata aja sih ya. Seperti kalian bisa menciptakan dunia fantasimu sendiri secara nyata, tapi kamu tidak perlu usaha yang keras. Namun dampak negatif atau efek sampingnya itu lebih banyak, apalagi sangat berpengaruh untuk kondisi mental kita. Ya, anggap saja kalau kalian sering melakukan lucid dream itu, bisa jadi kalian menganggap orang-orang di sekitar kita yang sedang berbicara atau sedang melakukan kegiatan itu tidak nyata. Dalam tanda kutip itu seperti hantu ya. Okay, this is all from me. If I have a lot mistake, I'm so sorry. And you can comment in this video. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to save our healthy. Janganlah untuk jaga kesehatan kalian semua, karena kesehatan adalah harta utama kita. Dan selamat menjalankan ibadah puasa bagi menjalankan. I am Alfer HD. I'm signing out and see you on the next video. Goodbye. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jadi lucid dream itu kayak
bagi-bagi orang halu ya.
Kalau menciptakan sebuah idol di dalam mimpi tersebut bisa ketemu langsung kan ajaib kan ya.